What's going on, everybody? It's Stas here. Welcome back to another video. So in today's video, we're going to be doing an overall market update as well as a trading update for me. And we're also going to be talking about why it is very important to understand market direction when it comes down to trading stocks in the stock market. So for those of you guys that are new to my channel, my name is Stas and I make videos dealing with swing trading, day trading, long-term investing, and my personal philosophies and strategies when it comes down to investing and trading in the stock market. So for those of you guys that want to learn more about that, feel free to drop a like, leave a comment, and subscribe, and follow me on Instagram as well as on Twitter, and join our Discord group chat as well as our Facebook group. All of those are linked down below in the description box. And if you guys want to talk to me throughout the day, as well as all of our 190 members, I guarantee you would not regret joining that Discord group chat because we're talking all day pretty much about trading, stocks, stock news, strategies, and a bunch of other different things. So again, all of those are linked down below in the description box. Now let's get right to the market update. So starting off with the Dow Jones today, guys, we noticed it was up 241 points. So green day overall throughout the entire markets, including the Dow, the S&P, and the NASDAQ. And if you guys remember that channel that we were talking about in yesterday's video and the previous videos that we were talking about, this channel is no longer valid due to the Dow Jones and the S&P as well as the NASDAQ breaking out of that channel. Let's say we bounced here where I thought it was going to bounce and push down in price. That means the channel will still be valid, right? But now that we broke out of that, you know, resistance point of the 50-day SMA in terms of the Dow Jones, we are no longer trading in that channel. But, you know, we've had two straight green days in terms of the Dow Jones and in terms of the overall markets. But do not let this trick you, guys. Do not let this trick you that the overall markets are recovering because, in my personal opinion, guys, the correction is still in effect. I still think that the overall markets are going to continue to sell off unless we are able to break out of this 180-day SMA line here, which has proven to be a resistance point in the past. And if we notice, guys, in terms of the price action of the Dow Jones on the one-day, one-minute chart, we notice that, okay, two straight green days, very nice, right? But there wasn't too much intraday movement today. Most of this, you know, was a gap up pre-market hours, and throughout the day we were pretty much hovering from 25,100 up to about 25,250. We got up to about 25,300 and then we aggressively sold off heading into, you know, the market close, and we ended up pretty much selling off at close to the low of day in terms of the Dow Jones here at about 25,100. So Dow Jones, guys, up about 1%, up about 240 points. And again, do not let these two green days in a row fool you. Do not make your assumptions that the markets are reversing just because of two green days in a row. I would not really think the markets are completely reversing until we break past at least this 50 SMA or this 180 SMA on this 180-day 4-hour chart. Now, looking at the S&P, guys, same exact thing, right? We were talking about that channel in yesterday's video and previous couple of videos, and you know, the S&P broke out of this one as well, and you know, is trading above the 50 SMA and the EMA here on this 20-day chart. But don't let this fool you, guys. I still believe that, you know, we are still going to be selling off in terms of these major markets. It's just that these two big green days were something that we needed after a bunch of days in a row pretty much selling off in the market. So S&P up about $29 today, up about 1%. And the NASDAQ actually had the biggest day out of all of these different indexes. We were up 2.2%, up about $153 in terms of the NASDAQ. And you know, this one is still downtrending, guys. This one is still pretty much trading below this 50-day SMA on the 180-day 4-hour chart. It's just slightly creeping up above it, but that does not mean that it's confirming the reversal quite yet. It is still technically downtrending. And I can show you guys this if I'm able to just clear all these drawings very quickly for you all, so I can just just draw a quick little trend line, remove all, what am I doing, guys? What am I doing? Clear drawing set. That's what I'm looking for. But, you know, if I draw this trend line for you right here, take a look at that. It's still downtrending in price, and I wouldn't be too surprised if tomorrow, I know I said this yesterday, but I was not really expecting a huge green day today because I still thought we were going to be trading in that channel, but this is all just educated guesses. But I wouldn't be too surprised if tomorrow we got rejected here and started to push down and sell off again, because we've had two straight days of about like 5% gain in the overall market. So guys, still downtrending overall, and I would not be surprised if we pull back, maybe not tomorrow, maybe on Friday, but next week I do believe we're going to be pulling back in terms of the stock market and continue this little correction that we've been in. So in terms of a trading update for me, guys, I actually didn't end up trading at all today, right? I was talking about this in the Discord group chat. I just wasn't really able to catch any movement today because most of the movement would have came if I bought in last night and held through the night into today, right? Because I told you, and we've seen the Dow Jones, the S&P, and the NASDAQ, these three main indexes, they pretty much gapped up overnight. Look at this gap up right here. This is something that I wasn't able to, you know, capitalize on because I wasn't in any stocks overnight except for TVIX. I'm going to talk about that in a second. But we noticed we closed at about 24,850 yesterday, and we gapped up all the way to about 25,123. So if I was able to put some money in a couple of overnight trades yesterday, I would have been able to capitalize on that. But since the market was overall kind of flat today throughout the day, although we did see this big gap up, I wasn't really able to catch much movement in, you know, the intraday plays in terms of different stocks and ETFs today. But, you know, one of my regrets from yesterday is actually selling out of Gush, because we saw Gush had a very fantastic day today in terms of percentage gain. We saw it was up about 12% at one point. And for those of you guys that recall, I was in Gush yesterday at about $19.60-ish, and I could have made 20% literally if I held overnight. That's one of my regrets for today. But you know, nothing can go perfectly as planned, right? No one really knew that we were going to have a huge day today in terms of the major indexes. So this is one of the bullets I have to bite, right? And I just move on to the next trade. But if we're noticing a bunch of these bear ETFs, they're slowly reversing during the latter half of the day today, especially drip. We hit lows of $8, closed at about $8.75. So that's a very good sign. And you know, this is mostly due to the overall market selling off heading into the close today. And I believe if we are able to continue to sell off heading into tomorrow, DRIP is going to be very good play tomorrow. LABD is going to be a very, very good play tomorrow. JDST has been opening up as a fantastic play as well. And this is actually one that I'm very interested in trading if we were able to hold above this 180-day SMA. We've literally shot up $15 in a matter of a couple of trading days. So if we're able to pull back maybe a little bit, if we break below this 180 SMA, if we're able to pull back to this 50 SMA, maybe at about like $68, $70-ish, I might consider taking a swing position there on JDST. But overall, guys, you know, a bunch of the large caps today had very strong days. Like Facebook had a strong day today, but if we notice, they're still in that downwards trending pattern. This one's having a couple of red candlesticks under the 180 SMA, and this is why I'm convinced that the sell-off is still in effect, right? We just had a bounce back day today and yesterday, but none of these large cap stocks are really showing any signs of a full on reversal. Let me show you guys a couple of other ones. So Facebook still downtrending, right? Let's take a look at AMD. AMD had a solid day today. This one's obviously still downtrending, right? Like, check that out, guys. Just because we had two straight green days does not mean that we can just hop into these large cap, or, you know, these big stocks thinking that, okay, they're going to recover over the next couple of days. This is something that's very risky, and that's why I ended up just sitting on cash today, because I want to see some more overall market movement before I end up taking any positions. And I want to really see how the futures end up playing out tomorrow, pre-market hours, before even considering, you know, planning any swing trades. So AMD still downtrending. Let's take a look at AMZN. Let's take a look at Amazon. This one had a bounce back day today, but again, it's still downtrending. Let's take a look at Google. Let's take a look at the biggest companies out there on the stock market, because these have the biggest weight on the overall market. So this one still downtrending. It's at a point of resistance under the 50-day SMA indicator, right? Let's take a look at Apple. Or not, it's AAPL. I always mess up Apple's ticker symbol for some reason. You know, same thing with Apple here. Still on this little downwards trending pattern, still trading below the 180 SMA, still trading right under there, right? So these are all at points of resistance right now. And this is why I do not believe that we're going to continue to push up. I think that the overall markets are going to sell off either tomorrow or maybe next week. We might have another green day tomorrow. Who knows? But I think we're going to be pulling back due to the technicals of all these large cap companies, you know, pretty much telling us that, right? So again, I could be wrong. I've been wrong in the past. And, you know, obviously I can't predict the future and no one out there can, but I'm just doing sound technical analysis based on the large cap companies that have the most weight in terms of the stock market. So guys, it's very, very important to understand market direction. Right now, the market is still technically downtrending, although we've had two bounce back green days. And another way to really just look at this is just take a look at the large cap companies that I just went through. Apple, Amazon, you know, Google, the big large cap companies that have the strongest weight on the overall stock market. Let's take a look at Netflix. This has a heavy weight as well. Still downtrending in price, not really showing any signs of a reversal, still trading below the 50 SMA. So you guys get what I'm saying here. All of these stocks, guys, none of them, literally not a single one, is showing signs that it's pretty much reversing in price. And I could take a look at my large cap, or I have a long-term investments playlist, not a playlist, oh my God, guys, a watch list. And these are big name companies, you know, large market caps. Let's take a look at Disney, right? This one's at a point of resistance, right? You know, let's take a look at Coca-Cola, right? This one, actually, okay, this one's different, but no one really trades Coca-Cola. You know, this is actually, let's take a look at Micron. Micron at a point of resistance as well, still, you know, downtrending in price. So pretty much, guys, the gist of this video is that we are not full on reversing and, you know, recovering in terms of the overall stock market. I still believe the market direction is pointing down. We're still selling off. And I do believe that we're going to be seeing a couple of red days over the next 1 to 2 weeks. I don't know when it's going to happen. No one knows when it's going to happen. But just the overall markets, guys, and after all this technical analysis, this is what I've come up with. So in terms of my position in TVIX, I'm down a decent amount on this position because, for those of you guys that didn't watch my video yesterday, I got in at $55. I sold off most of my position at $57 yesterday, right? Literally most of it, about 80% of my position I sold out, took a good amount of profit, and I left some shares on the board because I thought today we were going to have a red day. So I was wrong. I bit the bullet, but I did not cut losses because I believe, like I've been saying this whole entire video, that the sell-off is not finished. So I'm pretty much looking to average down on TVIX, maybe tomorrow, maybe the next day, but I want to keep those couple of shares. Literally, I only have like a handful of shares of TVIX, no joke. Like, it's a very small percentage of my swing portfolio. So even though I'm down like pretty much close to about 10% on this position, I'm not really scared whatsoever because it's a very, very, very small amount of my portfolio, very small amount of my portfolio, and I'm looking to average down because I personally think that the markets are going to continue to sell off. So You know, that's pretty much it for today's video, guys. You know, I'm looking to add more into TVIX if it's able to hold above this 50 SMA and if the markets are able to sell off tomorrow. Maybe bring my cost basis down to about 50-ish, 52-ish dollars, 53-ish dollars, because I do see a ton of upside in this ETF if the markets are able to sell off. And let's say I average down to $52, guys. That gives me a nice 15% profit margin up to previous resistance points of about $60. And that's really just what I'm looking to capture. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, feel free to drop a like, leave a comment, and subscribe, and follow me on Instagram as well as on Twitter. And join that Discord group chat if you guys want to, as well as the Facebook group. All of those are linked down below in the description box. And make sure to do your own research when it comes down to investing and trading in the stock market. Do not buy or sell based off of my opinion or anybody else's opinion out there, because that is not how you're going to become a self-sufficient trader and an investor over time, which is the whole entire idea and goal of this channel. So I'll see you guys in tomorrow's video. I hope you guys have a great night and a great day tomorrow. Peace out. Have a good one.